everyone. My name is Bhavika. I am a student of economics studying in Indraprastha College for Women, University of Delhi. Today, I'll be discussing about the balance of trade between India and China. I would also be throwing some light on the possible initiatives that India can take to reduce the trade imbalance with China. The relationship between the two giants of Asia, India and China, has been progressing at a tremendous pace. Today, they represent India, Asia's two largest and most dynamic economies, which are emerging as a new trendsetter in international relations. This relationship dates back to the year 1984, when India and China entered into a trade agreement, which provided them with the status of most favored nation. It was in 1992 that India and China got involved in a full-fledged bilateral trade relation. Both nations are fast-growing emerging economies with an annual average growth rate of about 7%. Yet, the growth trajectory of China has been much higher than that of India. It's very surprising that on one hand, the per capita GDP of India was higher than that of China in the 1990s, and on the other, we observe that it becomes about one-fifth of China in 2018. When it comes to trade, surprising as it sounds, the bilateral trade between these economies has grown fourfold in the past decade. But the trade is tilted more in the favor of China, contributing to an unfavorable balance of trade for India. More than the increase in imports, it is the composition of India's trade with China that is of real concern. The structural shift in China's exports needs to be seen in the light of China's planned strategy towards technology-intensive manufacturing and efforts to move up the global value chain. China's trade composition and structure has changed rapidly in the later years of 2000 due to privatization of export sector and large inflows of foreign investment. Also, contributed by trade liberalization and rising domestic content of exports. Chinese companies have huge investments in the cell phone business, telecommunication and power sectors. Such goods have become the backbone of India's own manufacturing. One of the reasons for the popularity of Chinese goods is that they are cheap compared to locally manufactured goods, as well as comparable imports from the United States or other Western countries. Although India's exports to China have registered impressive increase and have also contributed to the lowering of the trade deficit with its largest trade partner, there remains a significant concern that the recent export trends merely reinforce India's role as a supplier of raw materials and intermediates to China. Thus, in the absence of adequate manufacturing facilities that could have helped in processing the increased production of raw materials and intermediates, these products are being exported and India is foregoing domestic value addition. If India decides to put an embargo on Chinese goods and decides to import from other countries, it would involve a huge cost escalation, which would translate into rising cost of goods and services such as power generation. Similarly, the telecom and IT industries, which depend on import of hardware from China, will also be affected. This trade imbalance needs to be addressed for India and China to engage in sustainable trade relations. This gains credence particularly in the context of all the increased economic and trade cooperation between the two countries. Focus of this presentation is to critically examine the structure of trade between India and China and explore the possibilities for reducing these trade imbalances. During financial year 2019, trade deficit fell by $10 billion from $63 billion to $53 billion because of 31% surge in exports by India. It marks a turnaround as India's trade deficit has been gradually increasing since 2013-14. This was observed due to greater demand for marine products, grapes, cotton, plastic, raw materials in the Chinese markets, as these items were the ones that Trump assured China before the ongoing trade war. Exports of marine products to China witnessed a 346% jump in a period of 10 months. Robust export of cotton textiles to China has helped India reduce its trade deficit with the country. Cotton textile exports to China increased 69% between April 2018 and February 2019. In addition to dramatically increasing exports of cotton textiles, India imported less electronic items as the value of the rupee fell over the course of last year. This was also largely due to the fact that India capitalized on India's trade tensions with the US to boost its exports to the Middle Kingdom. However, there might be another reason why the trade deficit fell so convincingly. As global pressure increases on China to correct its trade imbalance with trading partners like India, China might have routed its export through Hong Kong to understate the extent of its trade surplus. This is a huge possibility, as during the same period, there was a sharp increase in Hong Kong's export to India of the same goods that India imports from China. It can be said that China is using Hong Kong to camouflage the real size of its sale to India, which has apparently led to a loss of $900 million for India. For instance, India's imports for mobile phone parts from China fell by 34.1% in 2018, while import of same from Hong Kong increased by 72.8% during the same time. Despite India being one of the largest manufacturers of generic drugs, it has not been able to export to China because of Beijing's protectionist policies. While Indian pharmaceutical companies exporting generic drugs to the United States and Europe, as most of the drugs have received FDA and European Union approval, it is quite striking that China does not allow imports of drugs from India. To cut the massive trade deficit, India has also been pressurizing China to open IT and pharma for Indian companies, but so far it has not taken an official form. Given these ongoing situations, India's balance of trade is under serious pressure. Now, I'll be throwing some light on the potential opportunities for India. Given the structure of China's imports from India, the possibilities for increasing India's exports will depend on the domestic demand conditions in China. If the growth in China's world imports of a product is increasing, then it would mean that domestic demand is rising, and therefore potential export opportunities for India would also rise, provided India has the supply capability. India has even submitted to China a list of 380 items, including agriculture, horticulture, pharmaceuticals, textiles, chemicals, tobacco, and some engineering products, where the country has the potential to increase exports, provided Beijing cooperates by lowering non-tariff restrictions. India would be able to realize the potential export opportunities if the global competitiveness of the identified products is high. China is a fast-growing market for pharmaceutical products with potential for rapid development and growth. With changing age profile and increased expenditure on medical care, the growth in pharmaceutical products is expected to be much higher. With China's target of bringing the entire population under health care by 2020, opportunities for exports of pharmaceutical products from India are likely to open up. A closer dialogue in the following areas is necessary. Firstly, cooperation agreement between Chinese and Indian manufacturers for identifying products that is of mutual interest. Secondly, joint ventures in setting up production facilities in China by Indian manufacturers. And lastly, Indian products given fast track registrations. A beginning has been made with export protocols being signed between GACC and the Indian government for items such as fish, fish oil, rice, and tobacco. But a lot more targeted efforts have to be made. Now, what can be the way forward? The strategy for Chinese investments abroad is not to focus in areas where they already have comparative advantage. Instead, focus in areas which enhance their technological capability. In aligning with these broad objectives of Chinese Overseas Direct Investment, that is the ODI, India's interest in the inward FDI from China can be based on the following objectives. First, to identify sectors where Chinese expertise and India's investment requirements coincide and from which both countries gain in terms of making exports more competitive. Second, to identify sectors where China and India can partner for developing new products. And third, identify sectors which are of importance to Chinese production facilities and can also increase India's exports to China and the world. India's trade imbalance with China has been increasing, particularly from 2006 onwards. As India's major exports to China are primary products, the above trade imbalance can be addressed if India is able to export finished goods and/or value-added intermediates and enter into China's value chain of manufactured goods. Thus, while potential export opportunities exist, there are market access barriers that emerge as major constraints for expanding India's exports to China. Given the immense growth potential in both the countries, deepening of trade and economic cooperation between the two countries in resolving these trade issues through dialogue and discussions is very necessary. Healthy trade between two countries has the potential to reduce tensions. The leaders of both the countries have so far shown flexibility in improving relations. India should reconsider imposing restrictions on Chinese goods, as it has the potential to aggravate an already fragile status quo. China, on its part, should help India reduce the trade deficit by importing generic drugs and IT-enabled services. One of the main reasons for this unfavorable trade balance is that India exports only raw materials like iron ore and copper to China. The deficit can be reduced only when China starts exporting value-added products. Unfortunately, the Indian manufacturing industries have to go a long way before they are geared up to export value-added products to China. Despite the Indian Prime Minister's Make in India initiative, India is finding it difficult to increase its manufacturing capabilities in a short time span. Until India is able to create a sound manufacturing base, it should refrain from imposing any unreasonable restrictions on Chinese goods, as it would stand to suffer more than China.